the Ten Commandments of man given to a man through the inspiration of I, Prince Buster. One, thou shalt have no other man but me. Two, thou shalt not encourage no man to make love to you, neither kiss nor caress you, for I am your man, a very jealous man, and is rendered lay low any other man that may intrude in our love. Three, remember to kiss and caress me, honor and obey me in my every woman fancy, 7 days a week and twice on Sundays, cause at no time will I ever be tired of IT hit.
The Red Air was born in Kingston, Jamaica, 1930, the 24th day of May. And that day, there was a riot with the Right Honorable Alexander Bustamante fighting for the working class people, and my mother named me Prince Buster from there.
Ah, earthquake, child, earthquake! Shaking Orange Street, this music will beat. Sure. Let go. Let go. Unless you're tired. And you want pop. Look how your face look like one of them old GOS bus. You're not hearing your spear and your front wheel function. You see, Orange Street is the music street. And that's the street that sells the beat. So when you see me come, don't run, cause I'm just about to have some fun. Man, let me help you in something you don't know right now. See ya. The prince comes out in Orange Street, and the beat starts to retreat. But if he goes back a bit further, he'll drop flat in Charles Street. The prince goes the left, the prince shows the right. Look at young Buster care of a fight. Man, he's trying to run, but how far can he run? Music. Don't you know that Keena is the world's greatest runner, and he'll run you down? And I'll ask Sonny Liston the Bear to hold you. And I let Muhammad Ali, the world heavyweight champion, lick the hell out of you. Man, stand up. Stand up and fight, if you're right. Earthquake on Orange Street. Earthquake, shake it. What's my one that work on? Just come back and I go on that work on. No work on. People say my Santa Claus come back without him ties. Sure. Search the man, you know. I'll find him what? Cool. Cool, Johnny. Say it cool.
Great. Great.
People say the prince was too young to face the man, but they did not know the prince had a plan. So the prince sung a song, and the song goes like this. Merry Christmas, partner. It's time to start. Merry Christmas, Santa. You're the first black Santa Claus. Thank the heavens you came. But man, where's your toys? Man, I'm the king, and the people say that I win. Orange Street is my street. I'll shake the beat with earthquake. Watch it. Earthquake. Solid earthquake. Earthquake.
1938. Can you remember your first musical influence as a young boy in Kingston?
I can remember doing things like Chattanooga Shoeshine Boy, and that was within Frank Sinatra. I used to love to listen to Dick Ames and Bing Crosby at that time. I was influenced by a lot of music, you know.
As a boy, which school did you attend?
Well, I attended Central Branch Elementary School, and I left Central Branch to St. Annie's Catholic School, and I finished up in St. Annie's Catholic School.
So what age did you leave school? How old were you when you left?
Close to 16.
When you left school, was there in you a calling to go to music, do you think?
Yes, because while I was in school, I used to sing at the Glass Bucket Club in Frank Lyman's dance troupe, Sing and Dance. You never get much money for that, you know, because you're a kid, but you were just good. And I worked like 3-4 times a week for the troupe. And then we were at the corner of Luke Lane and Drummond Street, not Charles Street this time, Drummond Street, under the light post. That's where we always gather in the nights and sticks and pans and play music all night long, you know. After school, we always just meet there and play music.
So, were there sound systems in Kingston at that stage of the game? Or was there still live bands?
There was live band and about 2 small sound systems, but they didn't rate to the band, you know. Sound system hadn't gotten that powerful as yet. The big band was still in force.
So you were singing and dancing with a dance troupe,
mm-hmm.
and you were still at school.
Mm-hmm.
You left school. Mm-hmm. What was the next stage in your musical career which brought you to where you now are?
Well, you had a sound system named Tom the Great Sebastian, right? And I was clowning at Charles Street and Luke Lane, a little further down Luke Lane, you know? And he used to play music at his shop all day long, you know, and crowds used to gather, dance in the street and listen to him, you know, and we heard a lot of music from him. I think his sound system had more influence on me than probably any other until my sound came, even Coxon.
And what year was this, Pastor?
I can only estimate it now to be...
roughly?
50s.
Early 50s.
Early 50s.
So there you were on street corners listening to Tom the Sebastian. Did you move with his sound, or did you just...
Yeah, we go to country with the sound because in the middle of the night by the Clovers, that knocked me out. I could listen to that day and night.
Well, romance is what I...
Mardi Gras by Fats Domino, Don't Let Me Down.
I want to know what's carnival for. Got my ticket in my hand. I'm gonna go to New Orleans. Got my ticket in my hand. I'm gonna go to New Orleans. And when I get to New Orleans, I wanna see the Zulu King. When I see the Zulu King down on the rampart in Jomaine. When I see the Zulu King down on the rampart in Jomaine. I'm gonna stay right there until I see the Zulu Queen.
Shirley and Lee, you know, Lee's gone.
I'm gone completely out of my mind. Beg you to love me sometime, 'cause your love is mine. Gone. Seems as though you've gone far away. I can't sleep both night or day. Please come back and stay.
Dead-eyed me down, so And then they got the Griffin Brothers, Marjorie Day and the Griffin Brothers. And I learned about all those people while I was there with Tom. I never actually worked with the sound. But you know, Prince Buster's a guy everybody loved, and Tom loved me, and I was there. I had good muscles, so I was always a good companion to people.
Now let's talk about your muscles, because you have a reputation as a boxer and a fairly good right hand.
It's not the right, it's the left.
It's the left, is it? Oh, it's the left.
They, you know, they think it's the right, but the power is really in the left hand. You know, Coxon tried to adopt it, you know. But he telegraphed his punches, you know. And sometimes people see it coming. But it's the left hand, you know.
So
it's the same left. It's the same left jab that goes out, comes back in, into a hook, and goes for the jab.
Were you actually a boxer then?
Yeah.
And you trained as a
boxer? I was trained by the middleweight champion of Jamaica, Sid Brown, and Speedy Baker, who also challenged him for the title, but Sid Brown knocked him out. And today, Speedy Baker is living in one of my buildings in Jamaica.
Yeah. Did you ever take your boxing career to any kind of professional status of fighting for money?
Yeah. Yeah.
At what age was that?
I had three fights. It was about in the 60s.
Really? While you were making music, you were also boxing?
Uh-huh. Yeah, many times I go to the studio, my mouth busting. I got to cancel for another day. Because somebody stuck the jab in my mouth in training or fighting or something.
The Coxon connection, was that after Tom Sebastian?
Yeah, that's where he knew me. You know, Coxon used to go to America and farm work, you know. And one time he brought up some records that were exclusive in the island. And he opened his little sound system. And his aunt used to have a shop in Luke Lane, a little below Tom. She also listened to Tom music. So, you know, he saw me there and he realized that, well, put it this way, at that time, at my young age, I was tougher than people bigger than me. So, you know, we got to get friends. And he told me that Duke Reed was giving him a hard time, you know, mashing up his sound. Any way he played, he couldn't play, bad men mess him up. Well, I said, okay, we'll go for it. So we went together, and I think we did a good job because Duke Reed, man, wouldn't mess with me. I solved all his problems. Quite a couple of bouts, but we won them all, you know.
Bang, bang, bang. And down they went.
Yeah, well, they don't stop too long because, see, I was born in West Kingston. I grew up in Bacawal and Village. My tutors are fighting with people like Don Frisco, Fancy Haggard, Blue Feather, from in West Kingston. In Bacawal, Brother Baby, you know, people like Papa Fifo. I grew up under some tough man. I grew up at a small age. I knew Baba John. He's a tough, big man, you know. Right, Weatherman. You must know Weatherman. He lived in England. He was my bodyguard 6 or 7 on the shows. These people were very smart. I look up and wonder if I ever grew to be strong and tough like them, you know.
What about this character, Whoppy King? Was he around then?
Oh, yeah. On the dungle.
He was a bad man.
Yeah, he growled. He was bad, man. I mean, not only bad, because you're kind of bad and still have good in you, but Whoppy King was sinister. You know, so nobody cares to remember him except for the history of Here Goes the Evil Man.
Sound system-wise, you've joined forces with Coxon. You're his protector, if you like. You take care of business when it comes to trouble at the dances. Did you actually then move on to select and operate Coxon, or was it strictly on a bodyguard basis?
No. Look here, with me and Coxon, we got to be the best friends. And we go out and look girls in the night. And hey, Coxon had a couple of fights with us in the night out, you know? You get drunk, you know, and just feel tough and start something. But I had to finish it.
Great.
You know? But
even with those big hands of his.
Well, with Downbeat, and it's my friend, you know? My friend. We have a lot in common. If Downbeat gets to hit you, you're going to go. Because I can tell you one thing. Mrs. Darlington and his mother fed him good. You know, he was well fed and he was nicely built. But he didn't know about boxing, you know. But he could punch, swinging. And if a swing hit you, he was winning a bout at that time. But I could only guess about 185 at the time. He had some power.
So did you, on the sound system circuit with Coxon, did you ever select and operate the sound?
Yeah, I do everything. I operate the sound. I kept the dance gates, the money, collected the money. And the biggest thing I did for Coxon, and this is where I left him, because a lot of people don't know how come Buster and Coxon could separate. You see, Coxon used to play against Duke Reed, right? And Duke Reed had more money than probably any other sound man existed at that time. So Duke could go to the United States very often and come with new records, scratch the label off so you never know, give it his own name. So Cox, the best, let me say this now, how would I say? I think the most important thing that I did for Coxon was to be able to go into Duke Reed Dance at night. First time he gonna play the records, listen to them, study. I used to study the guitar, the tenor, and by listening it, I could tell Coxon who the artist was. And by listening the words, I could pick out what I think the name of the tune was. I could also tell them the label of the record, so you go over there and get them and bring them back. We'd sell them for £5-10 a piece. But then one night, that's the night when the Scorpion bit me. You know? Coxon heard Duke Reed had just come up with a bunch of new tunes at Forrester's Hall, was the opening dance. So he took me to a place and we stood there listening to what he could see us, what he had. And while I was listening, telling the artist and telling him what, I let no one, the Scorpion bit me, you know, and I had to go to the hospital. Coxon went to America and got the tunes. And when he came back, he was supposed to give me a quarter of any amount of tunes he bring back for what I'm doing. But this was selling and I wasn't getting my quarter, you know. And I got a little bit upset about it and I got him some weed and I couldn't wait no more. Then he took on to, a guy called Paro. You see, these guys came, Paro was from Boys Town, and for some reason, he took on to him and put him at Barbecue Gate. That's the gate I used to keep. Well, the people East didn't like that and they ran him away. You understand? So I said, I can't bother with this. I just couldn't go out now. Do my own thing. So I just went out and released a certain amount of tunes that he didn't even know I know the name of. About two of them was from his selection.
When you say released, do you mean tunes that were from America?
Right. I'm telling you, two of them was in his box, and about five from Duke Reed, and that shocked him. I didn't know. So he kept worrying if I knew the name of Coxon Hop.
Oh,
for 7 years. And the name was Lake of Agita by Willis Jackson. But it was changed to Coxon Hop for him. Well, I didn't tell Duke Reed not to mind Bill Coxon, you know? But I went out and started doing things myself. Well, a situation existed in Jamaica at that time, whereas only certain people could have record shops. The poor people, it was like something they'd never touch. One Hard's own record shop, Chin's own record shop. Cox was selling a few records out there's little place. Duke was selling a few records out there's liquor store. But no real record shop except by like One Hard's and these people. But I think I wanted a record shop. So I went out and did it. And when the rest of Jamaica saw that I did it, many shares the record shop coming up after me. And everybody said they are firing Prince Buster. I led the way, man, and everything down there.
And where was your first, where was your record shop set up?
Luke Lane and Charles Street. And that is the womb, I would emphasize, womb. You know, that is the womb that delivered the music.
What year was that, Buster?
It's about 58.
And in those days...
57, 58.
In those days, you and Coxon and Duke, we weren't actually cutting records yourselves. You were bringing records in and selling them.
Bringing records. But listen, they had the visa. I hadn't a visa to go to the States. So bring up a very interesting thing. Coxon had visa. Duke had visa. They could go to the States. Now, immediately after I left Coxon, Duke Reed tried to hold me. He'd been trying to get me from Coxon for a long time. If it wasn't me, he would have finished with Coxon a long time. So when I left Coxon, Duke called me. He said, come on, you know you should have come a long time. You have Cutty, you have Pompadour, and all these men and you's friends and things, and you'd up on that side, you know, in the morning. So I said, Duke, I really come follow nobody. Yeah, Coxon is still my friend. Just don't treat me right in a certain respect or the other things. And come on, but if I can do some work, I can make some tune for you. At the studio, and if you stop import the tunes from outside, they pay me so and so. We come to an agreement, you know, and I went and make the tune, dad. I make Let George do it, Blackbird Brandy, and quite a few more tunes.
Now, these were boogie-style tunes. This was still 1958-59.
Yeah, but I was drawing the thing into it. You see, that was the difference between me and them. They wanted the boogie, but I was now pulling my book beat, as they call it, the ska, into the thing. That's why, because Duke could easily go to a studio and make boogie. They could buy a new boogie,
right?
You know? But nobody understand what was happening now, because there was sound coming out and they couldn't identify it, but the people was just dancing it.
And you recorded them where?
At Federal Studios.
And what year was that? Can you remember?
It was right in the 59. But let me tell you something happened there. Duke didn't pay me. Why? Because I went to One House. And these people like me. And I credit my speakers and thing, and it started a bit of sound. Well, the whole of Jamaica people was behind me, and he was trying to hold me back by keeping me on balance economically, not paying me so I could buy the equipment I needed for the sound.
You're talking about Duke Reed?
Yeah, Duke. So Coxon will tell you about this. So one day I went to his Duke Reed shop and said, Duke, I want my PA, you know? And Duke touch him gun, you know? And I told him, but hey, I didn't need to check for them gun, because them days I take with Duke gun and beat him all night and prove the next day, you know? So, not giving him a good response, I just go down to Federal. I went to Mr. Khoury, who won Federal Records. Mr. Khoury, leave the office, so nobody wants to say you're involved, because I'm going to do something today. And Mr. Khoury said, mine, Duke is a bad man, Buster. You know, I have a lot of men. I couldn't care, because to me this meant life. I meant to go, and he was holding me back. So he used to keep all his tapes in Federal Studio. And I just went down there to my spa and broke out the lock and took all the Duke Reed tapes. Put them in my bag and carried them away. Now, that is like taking away my belly. You know? The winch was stiff, because I was sitting about 2 cars with a back of a bad man, we had 7 tour. You know, 7-2, and Dapper Dan, and this is where the point was going to change now, right? Because I had these men, you know, Phantom, these men where I was
younger than them, and they were bad men. I was growing up, you know, looking at them, wondering if a clash one day. If I never sure if I would have win. I can't do the repetition, you know. But Duke will make a solve for him because he send them for me. Me and you, him, Carl and Philip, who did the job, you know, take the tapes then, was sitting down at 145 and a half Iron Street. That's how I was, you know, after the barn, after I left the lining. We had a knife pin in the ground and two cars just drove up. One came from the south and just stopped. Nobody come out, nobody say anything. We stood right there. Another came from the north, Black Weena. Then I hear 7-2 step out, you know, big and waddle out. I said, waddle out of the car. What in book? The boss wants you. Well, it's like something flashed in my head immediately. Because growing up with them in Bacawal, I knew what was the mission now. After I take the tapes today, somebody called Duke Reed, the student, went back to Mr. Corey. And Duke Reed came behind me and hugged me in some kind of beer hug thing. I don't know what kind of hole that was, but it had me for a while. And Duke said, Washington Boulevard. I'm a gang of man within 2 car, man. That means Washington Boulevard was still bushes. So I'm going to carry me out, they're going to kill me. You understand where that goes. So Mr. Cool said, Mr. Reed, if anything happened, I'm going to give evidence a bus. They bring all these big, ugly men into my place, kidnap a man. And while him turned to answer Mr. Corey, I just swing my foot up and stamp the gate was in front of me and break the wall. And for my break the wall, star butter, 2 bucks to me and 2 left hook and him fall. Was a fool if I did and him come out and say, the boss, well, me and Carlos get up and say to them, say, this mean life to you, right? One of those hired man. So if you're ready for them, let's come because I'm ready, you know, see? Well, 7-2 take 1 step and me take 2 hours, man, just go back to the car and sit down and say, he's a madman. I can't understand this, you know? So I say, I tell the woman though, go back to Duke and tell Duke, send a cab for me and my star them, Scarlett and Philip. We're not driving a cab, you know. My neck will win and choke with them, you know. I'm bigger than we. So then go to Duke and Duke's and next cab. And just, you go laughing already again, what really happened, you know. The next cab, we're going to Duke tonight, you know, the new cab, me and Philip and Carl. If you want to talk about business themselves. When I go in a Duke shop, the outside door closed. Duke have 52 men in the shop. And when I go inside, I see Duke and Pompadour drinking blackberry brandy. Because they started to drink that after tune that I made, making the tune famous, everything to do with blackberry brandy. I know the father just make a stick to my head right away, and Duke read up on top of the counter squat. Pompadour stand up and Cuttings and the rest of youth them and the bad man them line up against the wall. And I was going and just take with the bottle from Duke, don't say nothing to him, and just pick up a glass and throw that big drink, and I never even drink. You know, see, is that a thing that happened? Throw it in there and just gulp it down, pull my throat a little bit, but, you know? And say, Duke, saying, calm me now, what happened? You want me? Throw it all them boys out of your place. Because you can't talk a business because them not recording, man, all them there. Them that boogie yag, and I recording, man, them. And we not recording business, because you didn't pay me. And if you don't pay me, I can't get the tape, so what am I doing now? So Duke tell them to back up little. Because nobody know where the tape is. I tell them, say, they might burn it. Where I left it, the people might even burn it if I don't come back. But them say, come to my office. Go in the office, and Duke said, the 3 taxi must go out the night and bring back the tapes there. Now this news spread all over town, you know. From it happened, you have at least 1,000 people stand up, you know. So I'm looking for Duke kill me. I'm looking for different things to happen because sound system at that time is the biggest thing in the country. You see, and I take with Duke Berry. Anyway, we hold all night and we were driving up Irving Street about 3 o'clock. I saw my mother stand up at my gate, worrying what happened to me, so I stopped the car. And I come out and I said, but I look at her, I said to him, listen, we're not going to further tonight, you know. Tomorrow we do the tea. I'm just going to my yard, my mother. So the morning I wake up early and go to Duke and Charles, that's the bass. That's my friend there. Guess who comes again? After all the people that Duke will stand up, you know. Big time 7-2. Walk come out of my corner. Swing power. Right? Duke want the tape, and if you don't bring the tape, no one will be happening. Well, no a long knife now, man. And call him a small knife. And call us pass me the small knife. Right? And grab a waist. I mean, just grab a waist back. The size gone out of my mind. I don't know 7-2 as a man now. You know? And look at things going right there, so. And then pick off and start running. And they run him down Charles Street, down Iron Street, and run him out of water. You know, see it? And then go back to the big man, you know, and show them so well. When tell them, you know, I can one day assume I didn't tell them it's hot out there. Well, Mrs. Reed, Duke's wife, is a lady where I have a lot of respect for.
The Duchess.
The Duchess. And I can repeat that, the Duchess. She's a Duchess. And Mrs. Reed pulled up on the phone and said, Buster, bring the tapes to me. Give me. I don't want you to have nothing to do with Reed. At that time, Reed have some swelling for him, you know, see? I'm ignorant. I said, Miss Reed, you know, say I'll give you the tape then, but what to my money? And she said, don't worry about anything, McCarthy. Don't give the money. After you give me the tape, I gonna let him. No, I didn't want you nothing more. So I go back home, take out the tape them out of the box. And the truth is, you know, you wanna see how tax now we had the tape, you know.
It was toxic.
Sure. That picture is a man still there with the man.
Yeah.
You know see?
Up, you lick him down in bunks right back. What a hard man for dead. Pick him up, you lick him down in bunks right back. What a hard man for dead. Them say the cat got a 9 life, but this man got 99 life. Cause them pick him up, them lick him down in bunks right back. What a hard man for dead. Them wild, one pot of chocolate tea, and all the fried fish they caught in the sea. They also got 6 quart of rum. Say that they waiting for the 9 nights to come. The last time I heard them say that this man was dead. Them biting blacker eyes and them lay it all upon his head. Now the procession leads to the cemetery. The man Allah, how don't you bury me? You pick him up, you lick him down in bunks right back. What a hard man for dead.
Sound system up in this way by the dance. What's that from the tape? So I put the box on the shelf. And everybody said, hey, tape come. So I just called you and Miss Reed. I said, listen, if you was trying to trick me, you'd have tricked yourself. But since everything's serious now, I didn't get my money. I didn't get a tape then. But if you don't give me my money, this time you curtains close. You know? Well, Mr. Stuart, I opened the box and said, see the Duke? See the tape in there? Duke shocked, threw him to the box. And when I did that to show him that I was using my head to. I wasn't just a forceful man without direction. You see? Well, Mr. Reed said, Buster, trust me. I said, yes, man. You know, I love you like a madman. What are you talking about, Mr. Reed? So I just kind of flipped 2 blocks away. I said, come on, the tape, man, I'm bad. The tape dropped. Duke Reed hugged me up. Even Lee says, my other spike there for. I said, Prince, I don't want me to happen.
So right? You're cold from that?
What do you mean? I don't want me to happen. And I'll get forget all this. And you must forget everything. And stay amongst me and thing, man. I don't know what happened, but I should have paid your money. And about 3 days after, yeah, the money come. Plus, 500 copies of each of the record that I make for him. To my new little record shop with the star. You see me? I want it to go, you know. I mean, I do everything to make it go. And I couldn't take nobody to stop me. No matter what kind of name you have, Prince Buster had to come. Right, and let me tell you this, Drupal wasn't solved yet. Oh. With all the embrace and things, and we had a nice 2 or 3 months big time. But the more the news came around that my sound was almost finished, was the fire we were getting again. Drupal didn't want anybody to come challenge for him number one position. But a man named Mr. Morrison, he said to me, sir, if you just give him £500, and him give me a 3-decker hand. I can't shake down any one of them. And I go with him. And one ad, trust me some speaker, credit me some speaker. Nice big getting me speaker. And me and my little youth them get together and get bored. I make the box them. Cabinet make a health way and nice, we come out clean and nice. The big thing was the work them dance me. And the whole crowd around, Buster come, Buster come, Buster come. But I tell them, say, all the other sound systems satisfy to be number 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And officer come like Buckingham Palace, you see, because no man not trespassing a Duke with handcuffs and thing. But that is the top. And I figure, say, that's where I should be. So I just challenge both of them at the same time when I come. Why wasn't doing it with no violence thing in mind? But I should have known say to have bring that inside it if I take the lead. But the first night I play, Forrester's all opening dance. Machuki was coxing, man, this jockey, no, my this jockey. I'm the part two. If I get the money and just leave, though, come with me. Big time sound, everybody shot, news spread. Duke sent to me and say, I must send him the sound. See, mad man, we come for the top. Well, the following Sunday night, first contest of me and Duke Reed. To leave this, you know, how should we feel? Duke at Chocomo, I at Carnival. Duke knocked me down, I forgot it, knocked me down. Okay, and flopped my dance early and with all the crowd. But I know, say, I have some music where I make, and it's supposed to tap. So I tell Machuki, turn the hand up to Duke dance. And take out some money, I don't know how much it was, right? And give it to him, buy him a box of beer. And about 10 of in the dance. I said, steal this and don't stop. He must stop there for a week. We don't have nobody here. He must have all the crowd. We just come. We're fresh. But don't stop playing. Oh, play, 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 play. See him start repeating himself in his dance. I check out more of the records. And my record, I tease said to go over there. And about 12 in the night, people just start streaming down to my dance, and then my dance gets found few more empty. So them say they want the next contest the next week. I take Chuck and one give him Carnival. Okay, done. And he goes to hold the Duke and it's done. I wonder if it beat Cox now. But Cox no want to dance near me. So some man of Weston just keep some dance and sit me for first as I my Jubilee. And down quick, quick, quick. And his name is pure Prince Buster. But then I want some exclusive music. So I want money to go to the studio. I them still have the input, both local and import. But I visit like a morning and go to Mr. Kuri. Mr. Kuri, you know, everybody likes to know me come to sound and say, all right, boss, stop. And I don't worship in the studio time, just to make music. I know you love music. I go in there and badap, badap, badap. Me and Monty Morris and Basil Gabidan and few more youth, you know, and we call it some shaka. Duke Reed pay me £30 one copy of each of them record by me. Just play it exclusive. Don't get nobody else. Just me and him play it. I like play it myself. But at the same time, I need money to go and build the sound the way I want it to go. So I never give him everything. But he get empty dumpy the grass and he want that kind of dance can't keep putting up empty dumpy. So he say, yeah.
There was an old lady who lived in a shoe, had so many children she didn't know what to do. Gave them some broth without any bread, beat them soundly and sent them to bed. Whoa. Sat on a wall, Humpty Dumpty had a great fall. All the king's horses and all the king's men couldn't get Humpty together again. Whoa, 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 whoa.
So yeah, but then I have flopped them hard. Everybody's just Buster, Gold Coast, Palm Beach, and Red Dance gives us Buster. People march with our green bush on the street and it's Buster. I must remember when I do them things then. Them people are big man. Me and little boy, I mean start, you know. And it's a means people say little boy I go out with all these things. But still the power was the people. The same people. Well, go on and go on and everything nice and dance a fool and Prince Buster, Prince Buster. So I say, all of a sudden you are big time nice come up. And I want you to know this Radigan, because I straightened out already. But I'm gonna ask me again about it. Siaga give me sound. This sound I come from South Lane. I just trust my things from one odds. Every time I keep a dance, I have to carry a certain amount of the money. I'm peeing one odds to get the next speaker. Siaga give me sound. I get mother and scare my receipt on a side lane and spread them out in the street and thump up two man more than things and show them some move. Me and my man, nobody not give me nothing. Well, this was they must try to get my political life, same thing against some of the people who belongs against it. So I say, that's soft. So let's go next to that and say, don't believe them people. I have done no wrong. These bad-minded people want to see me go down. And you know this? They got to come. A whopper.
Don't believe them people. I have done no wrong. So will you kindly help me? Help me to sing my song. These bad-minded people like to see me down, but when the game is over and over, I can't go down. They got to come, they got to come, they must come, they got to come, they got to come, they got to come, they got to come my way. They have been grudgeful people. Oh, what a hurt have I done? These bad-minded people want to see me go wrong. So I sing Kibrilla Amla, and that's the name of my song. And when this fun is over and over, I can't go wrong. Thank you.
got to come. They got to come, they got to come. They must come, they got to come. They got to come my way. They have been grudgeful people. Oh, what the hurt have I done? These bad-minded people want to see me go wrong. I sing Kibrilla Amla, and that's the name of my song. And when the game is over and over, I can't go wrong.
You can't hear the story I can't give. This guy's missing it, and it's supposed to be exclusive. I'm playing Busta Soul. Really? One night I sent my song to play at Chocomola in West Kingston where I grew up. With a brother named Dan Dan, I played the disc jacket and play. Come and I put a car and my boys. I play. Me always play cricket in the street. Everybody comes to me play cricket in the street. So I have the bat and me and a man to say, a gang of man up there want to mash up his sound. So I jump on a bicycle and ride, go up there. When I go, I see Kyle, Redhead, Dub, Rubber Dub, Allen Monday. Guys, they must know how they keep it in their mind. Trying to turn over my arm, so I go and start chop them with. And pull out my blade and them start to back for me, advance to them. Well, the one we name Redhead now, I run off time and run through the gate. And I hear them running behind me now. And all of them, I turn back and face them. And the man just come behind me and crack my skull. I never even drop, you know. I roll up on the cane cat and drive the cane and match it. And I see them, but they was blurry running down the street. Well, me and my little cousin, Billy Moss, Avenger Island things than all that era cool. But those Duke would send them to do that to me, so hey, me and Duke never stop fight. You know, me and Duke stop fight. About 3 or 4 years before him dead.
Really?
Yeah, that kind of cancer.
Yeah.
So I'm a pray to the good Lord now for his soul. But Duke was, anybody will tell you that, you know. I come up with it was rough and tough, and I survived that.
Don't be scared, stop acting weird. Soon we shall meet on our street. This music is sweet, man, I've caught your beat. You heard the news, old pal, now don't run away.
Oh, sweet feet,
rocking down Orange Street.
Oh, sweet feet,
shaking up Orange Street.
Oh, sweet feet,
I'm coming in peace with my face to the east. Don't get upset, you live to regret. You must show me respect, and don't you forget. Like a fish in the sea, you're caught in my net.
Oh, sweet bee,
rocking down Orange Street.
Oh, sweet bee,
shaking up Orange Street.
Oh, sweet bee.
To conquer, cause I got the honor. My crown you can't wear, it will put you in fear. And if you slip up your slide, and if you run you can't hide, cause I got a whip stuck right in my hip now.
Oh, sweet bee,
shaking up Orange Street.
Oh,
rocking down a loose street.
Oh, sweet beat,
upsetting the stomach.
Oh, sweet beat,
in the belly.
Oh,
take the goat. Time will heal all the heartaches you got. Time will heal all the heartaches you got. Just meekly wait and murmur not. Just meekly wait and murmur not. Today for you, tomorrow for me. Today for you, tomorrow. The blind will be able to see. Even the dumb will be able to speak.
How long can you play hide and seek? How long can you play hide and seek?
Tried your best to keep me down, but I got music to hold this down. Now your world is upside down, as history eats itself and you were on the ground.
In the first part of the Yara Time Langer Than Rope, the beginning it was like 59. You had one set of tune from 59 to 60, then 60 to upward, right? But these 59 tunes were done to keep the sound system on top. That was the motivation. You understand? After that, now, then came things like a wash, wash.
Wash, wash, wash my
cross and wash all my troubles away. Like that lucky old sun, give me nothing to do but roll around heaven all day. So don't you hear me?
Wash, wash, wash my troubles.
What about Burning Creation, Everybody's Scar, songs like that?
Yeah. Burning Creation was done, I remember the time, I was now playing at Barbecue in Fleet Street. I had taken another place of Coxins to play down here every Friday night, as everybody got, and as my son playing now. I did Burning Creation to suit the situation that existed right here.
Daima Zima Wandalim! My people, you can see that I am no liar. And this fellow has now called me the burning fire. This is a fire for my party and desire. And by this sit back, relax, and admire. Creation, oh creation, what a mighty, what a mighty, oh creation, take creation, build a nation, so listen happy, rest in your nappy, and don't you copy.
What about black-haired Chinaman?
Oh, that's the history of himself, right? And Jamaica still look to everyday man type about that series between the contest with me and Derek Morgan. That really excited Jamaica because we're both singing songs about each other.
You done stole my belongings and give to your Chinaman. God in heaven knows, he knows that you are wrong. Are you a Chinaman? Are you a black man? It don't need no eyeglass to see that your skin is black. You prefer your Chinese man to your fellow black man. Speak up, friend. It's plain to understand. It won't be very long. They'll have a change of plan. To use you. Use you and use you, then refuse you. As you are the first black head shiny man, I did not know your poor parents were from Hong Kong. Every man has a right to where he belongs. So declare yourself and tell me where you are from.
What about all the business with the Judge Dredd in court, or which is moving on later now musically to a slightly rhythmically a different era rather than the ska?
You mean like Usher? Yeah. Judge Dredd. You see, I love the Jamaican people and I grew out of that continent concept of love, people universally. And what was happening? So some of my same friends on team, but what was happening at that time? It joked me. The guys weren't thinking about the whole of body and take off them things after them. People, that's why people love me, so no, they know like, I fight plenty. But most of a fight is defending the weaker person, so getting back to people. You know? So what I was doing at that time is like harassing the donkey people that hurt. When I say the donkey people, I don't mean to degrade them in no way, but I am from the donkey people. You understand? But the donkey is the symbol of the Democratic Party. The common people, that's what I mean, the common people. They wouldn't touch the rich man. Because the rich man had guns to shoot them back and have money to handle the situation. Them a wreck Jamaica and nobody can say nothing. And since I am from them, and I am there with them, Almighty God said talk, and I just go out there and say, hey, if not stop this, hey, you know, just sing song against them. And them say, ooh, boy, boop it off a go, sir. And me just say, well, it's a mashup of society. I'm just going to cool and try them myself and give them 400 years. That means I tell them, say, hey, you're not fit up on the earth. Because I use, use like a nuisance to people. So, Emmanuel Zachariah Zaki Palm, he died in the same can a role play in harassing people and people after killing. George Gabon flee, him dead right in the market. Grab a man things and run through the market gate and like a market police, when we cocky close, shoot him. And I shoot them saying, I say, you can't win, you know. It's a matter of time before everything close in.
Now my court is in session, will you please stand? First, allow me to introduce myself. My name is Judge 100 Years. Some people call me Judge Dredd. Now I am from Ethiopia. Try hard you rude boys for shooting black people. In my court, only me talk, cause I'm vexed, and I am the rude boy today. Who gun yes?
Yes, sir.
Rude boy Adolphus Jakes?
Yes, sir.
Rude boy Emmanuel Zachariah Zaki Palm?
Present.
George Robin Free?
Present.
Adolphus James?
Yes, sir.
I see where you have been charged. 10 shooting with intent. 5 murder charge, 6 grab and flee charge.
But you are not.
Hush up! Guilty or not guilty?
Not guilty, sir.
I don't care what they say, take 400 years, stand down. Emmanuel Zachariah Zaki Palm?
Yes, sir.
You've been charged 15 charge of shooting intent, 15 murder charge. And I heard that you was the one down there in Sutton Street who tell the judge rude boys don't care. Well, this is King Street and my name is Judge Dredd and I don't care. Now take 400 years.
But I don't know what you're going to say, you know, Your Honor, because
hush up, what are you trying to do, shoot me too?
No, Your Honor, but I didn't shoot a man.
Well, quiet.
You,
400 more years for you, George Robin Flea.
Yes, sir.
Stop your crying. Rude boys don't cry. That's what I hear.
I didn't read you no sir. Women, I don't give you a chance.
I don't hear. Hush up. This is my court. You're charged for robbing school children. Robbery aggravation.
Good man, I take my sentence to you, no sir. Is you shooting man, you know? I used to remember I just have a judge come up and try, you know, sir. I take my sentence to you, no sir.
Oh, sure. Harder. Adolphus James.
Yes, sir.
You rob school children. You boom the people's house. You shot black people.
But you and I don't
do. Oh, sure. Just for talking, I now charge you for contempt, and that is a separate 100 years. I hereby sentence you to 400 years. I said, hush up. You are sentenced to 400 years and 500 lashes. I am going to set an example. Rude boys, don't cry. When I was in Africa, I hear you were tough.
No, sir, I'm not guilty, no, sir.
Put a turn, take him away.
Well, I think Judge Dredd did a lot because Judge Dredd straightened out a lot of youth because they realized, just take a second look. It's 40 years of workhouse, you'll get life term, and prison was 400. So a life sentence is really 400 for the black man at that time. So Judge Dredd played part, and then we had Ghost Dance.
What a classic record. That is one of my all-time favorite records of yours.
Yeah.
That is such an atmospheric, eerie,
well,
soulful record. It's got so much atmosphere in it.
Yeah, it meant a lot because...
Faster.
It meant a lot because a lot of my best friends then, me and them grew up in a side lane, back lane, you know? Up Oxford Street. Band Street, and I'm up and down from St. Anne's School, and I'm just gone. Purple and stinky. We have a group of Purple and Stinky and Players too, and Jaisi Poo and Bunny and Gupti and Matom. It's mainly about youths now where who knew they might better them living condition one way or another. You see, that was a sweet session. But the letter was to my friend them who dead down in a boneyard. I know this since I come, quite a few men ask me, what is boneyard? So I'm glad they have the opportunity to express it on your program. Boneyard is simply the cemetery. But I Prince Buster couldn't just say the cemetery. So I have to get a Prince Buster touch. Boneyard.
Who's that? Dear Kitos, my friend, good day. Hoping you are keeping the best of health. How is the music down there in Boneyard? I hear that Busby have a sound system. And that Naya Keith is this jockey. But them can't get no red stripe beer for selling a dance at night. Tell Zaki, the high priest, who used to lead the toughest, one who could go, toughest. Give him my regards. Tell him, Prince Buster says, hello. Rashi, you know Rashi from Bahawal, give him my regards. And if you should see the two brothers, Stinky Pommels and Kurban, we go together, tell them, Prince Buster says, so long, sorry we had to go so soon. Since music be the food of love, I'll forever sing on. And first as all, we'll soon get back on ship.
What about Texas Hold'em and shaking up Orange Street, freezing down Orange Street, all those great tunes?
Well, shaking up Orange Street. Orange Street was a beat street. Everything musically came down Orange Street. And Coxon was at Love Lane. And Coxon moved across to Orange Street while I am at Luke Lane, just around the corner. But it is not on Orange Street. But a band, I live on Orange Street. My shop is around here. So I just buy the place exactly in front of him. I look straight on him now. God, the competition that, I mean, like competition. Look straight on him face to face. I ever said, brother, so. Right? And I come with some music and make earthquake on Iron Street first. Teasing Coxon. That is what the earthquake on Iron Street really doing. Teasing him. Well, shaking up Iron Street now was the music where I have because I shook and shake and took Iron Street. So shaking up Iron Street was showing him, say, a versatile music.
What about O Carolina, the Folks Brothers? That's a classic.
Well, O Carolina was a lot of thoughts and thinking, and I like to create sound. And I went to count Azzy up at the hill until Azzy said, I'll put him on record. Now I used to listen to Azzy. I used to walk for miles. Anyway, Azzy play. I used to stop and listen to him, the drums, right? But Azzy didn't think the drums could have gone wax. So we convince him, so yeah, make we try it, and my money was spent, so make we try it and carry the art. I booked JBC Studio. This is the important thing with the fight with Duke Reed. And when I reached JBC Studio with my little group, Duke Reed buy out the studio and in there with a big time band. And when I got the man, I said, but it's my studio and I buy time. And I said, boy, I'm looking, I don't see my name nowhere in the place. when I get a little bit disturbed, and that's why I love Johnny Moore, you know. Yeah, man, I was going to mash up the whole thing the night in that place, and Johnny Moore just hold me and say, "Boop, cool." And a man named Cecil Watt, working at GBC, just see, I mean, I must know some of some stubborn things at night. And him say, "Come and carry me in a room upstairs, a little place like this." And him take some little board and things and set up. I'll put us in a location, I'll put Wayne Gray. Just to learn to play a piano, and he says, "Hold in through card, you know, see it?" And Wayne Gray, because Wayne Gray up on a piano there, you know. And me over here, so I keep the thing, the tempo one behind a clap, the tune. And Skeeter and Bunny, I help the same thing. And we do it, we come out. Rastaman never have nothing for you to identify him out there. And him just some character chuck him one plate and some long locks, man. Bang, tang, pa, bang, pa, tang. So what? And the music sound called a boy's tone, and we never even plan the dance, you know. We just go in and start play. And by about 9 o'clock, the dance cock. Now that's piece over the next man. And we have a next one called Casavuvo. Chubby, you call it, or Drawweed.
Chubby.
You know? African blood now is Raymond Harper, and I will respectfully say that I'm a fan of Johnny Moore, but I don't know who to choose. Johnny's a stylist, but Raymond have tone. But I lose that trumpeter over a problem I have with him family. I'm selling out the house and don't get money. I go straight to him. And Raymond just start playing for the birds, you know? Go to the park and see a bird and just blow their hand. And they have nothing to do with them, you know?
Yeah.
So, you need somebody else to help him now, you know? Money can't buy it for the big lick, you know. Monty Tutu was Chuck Jamaica, was Pumpy Dumpy and Monica and by life. And as I family them together, as the youth them host me, and nobody wanted to be a star and a singer, and I like him. Because me like plenty girls, and him like plenty girls, and two have a whole of girls.
While I was walking along one bright and sunny day, these are some words that I hear some people say. If life was a thing that money could buy, the rich would live and the poor would die. Money can't buy life. Money can't buy life. Money can't buy life. Whoa, money can't buy life. Although I'm not rich, you can still be my wife. And let's live together for the rest of our life. I know someday, no matter what they say, before we go old, money will come my way. Money can't buy life. Money can't buy life. Money can't buy life. Whoa, money can't buy life.
What about It's Burke's Law?
That was part of the creativity in me. I'm in the studio and just finish a good recording session. But to me, it's still a sound to see me like the records up on the street. And I just called John Deegan and Bobby and said, listen, I'm going to try a thing and I want you to play this and you play that. I always tell them what I want to play. You play this, I play that. And I just go up on the mic and simple, I say, click, clack, click, 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 and just look at the solo with Bob Brooks. And boom, I hit.
It's Burke's Law!
St. Kitts and Nevis, your time, 484-5255, Christmas messages for St. Kitts and Nevis.
What other musicians did you use in that era? Names?
Well, my star player was my drummer, John Beagle, Jada Cancer, right? He used people like blues and bass. Well, from the beginning, Jah Jerry is Jah Jerry. My star guitar, that. It's showing how to change. We call it, you know, change gear. We had something going on in music with me and Jerry Way. Caxton and Duke couldn't get it. They had to hit, they had to kidnap, when I say kidnap, not hold him and take him away. But they had to send people, but influence Jerry to come give them two tunes. You know, Jerry. CMUT is snapping, you know.
Theophilus Beckford.
Great brother. And Gladdy. I had two piano players. Theophilus and Gladdy.
Horns?
Jerry. Well, and Hans now, same like a Johnny Moore. That Raymond did came after, you know. Johnny Moore and, that's his name, two boys of them come from Azide. Guineer. Bobby Guineer. You know, Stanley Ribbs. Saxophone. That was really the principal star. Others came and do some parts me and go. But that was the principal star.
Madness, madness, we call it madness. Madness, madness, we call it madness. It's plain to see. That is what they mean to me. Madness, madness, I call it madness. Madness, madness, we call it madness.
Can you remember this?
Madness, madness, we call it madness. I'm about that someone is using his brain. Madness, madness, they call it madness.
All the hits and more on 194.
Propaganda ministers, propaganda ministers, I've got a aim in view. I'm gonna walk all over you. Cause madness, madness, I call it gladness. But if this is madness,
you know, Prince madder than mad.
You're not mad.
This was, oh, listen, I said, I had to, you see, that's why I had to study all these, you know, study religion and things, because these are big men I fight against the sound, and them try some serious joke, you know. Them set up my life quite a few times, and escape. But it's a madness. That was one of them propaganda attack. When them find them couldn't do it physically, them try to swing at the town and say, I'm mad. You know, you want to see me sing, you know. And I do a wood, I do all, you see me not help, you know. I mean, I run the sound, I mean, I sing, I mean, I sell in the shop, I mean, I do everything, I mean, I fight people, I mean, everything. So you're young, and you get exhausted. You know, see, you know nothing about this, you just lay down. And the doctor tell me, say, man, all you need is some rest, man, you've been overdoing it, you know. And I lay down, and I get rest. And while I rest, and I enjoy all the rest of me, and feel nice and things. A man just come in and say them out the street, I say mad. And the thing is, old Jamaica, Prince Buster mad. People say, they want to the sound. They want to the record shop. They want to all them car things. Who get that? Them start to all talk things about me as if my guy in a mad house and can't come out back. I mean, if I'm in a mad house tackle, you see? So, Raymond Harper used to come to me every day, dying for me to feel good to come out, come work in the studio. I'm just now one day and say, ah, part them taste so mad, right? So, I write a song last night. You want to look on it? I show it to Harper. Harper said, madness is gladness. What do you mean by that? I say, well, if them out the confused and say me mad, I mean, I'm quite happy and working. Me have money. Me have good health and feel. Me have everything. Then me not happy. So for them madness and my gladness. So after I say, yeah, and get the knock. And we rehearse it sick, you know, rehearse the whole day in the house. And a week after, we just get up and go to the studio. And call the band together. And go out there and take pose, you know. So, me, that me have nice shape and things. So me take pose and say, see me, I'm right. I'm mentally me equipped, nothing to do me. Madness is gladness. 4 million seller.
Al Capone.
Old guns don't argue. Well, da de da de da do da de da dang da ding dang dung dang. I create all that. You see, to keep the sound pant up, you have to make instrumental to better the instrumental that Duke and Cox na play. You see, the vocal play later on in the night. You hear some more sound system. You couldn't have a sound system and you have 20 good instrumental. Those instrumental play from the dance start from 8 until about 10:30, 11. After you put them aside and you drop your vocal now when everybody in there dance nice. But the attack, the opening attack was just instrumental, instrumental, instrumental. So that was why I see it. Why could I really outplay them a little longer? By having that da-dang, da-ding, dang, dung, dang, ding, dang, dung, dang, di-dang, da-ding, dang, dung, dang, ding. And I saw it go.
And you
so we just, no, same time I show come to Jamaica, you know. I say, just the guns don't argue. And I always feel some of those Al Capone, so we just get the group together and say, hey, Al Capone guns don't argue. I chikotopa,
and a classic record was born.
Like that. And I want to thank you for your efforts in making this great show, the great Sunsplash. And listen, man, let me tell you one thing. It's important. I check myself in my bed when I sleep in the hotel and I say, when last Prince Buster you ever happy so? 20 plus years ago, when I kept a house in that, Palm Beach and the whole place black, that's the same happiness came back. I was a happy man, son. I did a good job, and I'm happy I was here to work on Sunsplash. God, this is a Sunsplash.
Prince Buster, thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Radigan, for being in your show, man. The irony.
The 10 commandments of man given to all man through the inspiration of...